Hi students, coming to our next topic, that is deadlocks. So what is a deadlock? Actually, a deadlock is a situation in which two or more transactions are waiting for one another. Okay, so a deadlock is nothing but it is a situation. It is a situation in which two or more transactions are waiting for one another. To give up locks. Okay, so that is a deadlock. So you call it as, suppose two transactions are waiting for one another for lock sharing. Okay, suppose here a T1 transaction is there and the T2 transaction is there. So T1 holds lock X and T2 is holds lock Y. Okay, T1 has read the operation and it wants to read the Y operation, but it is already holding T2. Okay, and T2 is waiting for TX. So whenever the transaction T1 completes its X and Y operation, then it is successful. So T is, if you want T2 transaction successful, it has to do the operations of X and Y both. But here, after completion of X, it is waiting for Y. After completion of Y, it is waiting for X. But here, those two locks are locked by transactions. So this case, you call it as a deadlock. Okay, T1 is waiting for, T1 is waiting for T2 and T2 is waiting for T1. So this case, you call it as a deadlock. Okay, suppose you want to go out with your friends. You want your friend to call you. Okay, at the same time, your friend is also wants to call you. So you're waiting for your friend call and your friend is waiting for your call. So both are in a waiting state. Okay, here no one is calling. So he is waiting, he will call. And that person is waiting that you will call. Okay, so that situation is, you call it as deadlock. Both are in blocked conditions. Okay. One is waiting for another call and another is waiting for your call. So that situation you call it as deadlock. Suppose you take resource R1. Okay. Process P1. Process P2. Resource R2. So here two processes are there, P1 and P2. Okay. P1 is waiting for R2 and its resource R1 is already assigned to P1. R2 is assigned to P2 and P2 is waiting for R1. So here this is in deadlock condition. You can observe this process P1 is already assigned a resources R1. So it's holding the R1 resources and it is waiting for R2. Okay, whenever it is having R1 and R2 resources, then this process will be completed. But here R1 is already assigned to P1. Okay, but R2 is assigned to P2. So ikkada R2, so here the P2 is assigned to R2. Okay, so and this P2 is waiting for R1. Okay, so process P1 is holding R1 and process P2 is holding R2. So now if this process wants to complete its operation, it requires R2. But this R2 is blocked by P2. Okay, and this, suppose if P2 wants to complete its process, it has the R1 values. But R1 is blocked by P1. So this case you call it as a deadlock case. Okay, let us see the example how the deadlock will be occur in transactions. So suppose take two transactions T1, T2. These are the two transactions. First you apply lock, exclusive lock on X. So I already discussed in the previous line, that is in the lock based protocol, lock X means exclusive lock. So it do both read and write operations. So whereas lock S means is a shared lock. Shared lock can perform only read operations. Okay. So let us take T1 is lock X, exclusive lock on X data item. So after that data item read and write. Now the T2 is lock Y. So it is lock the data item. So lock exclusive lock on data item Y. So after that locking, it is reading the data item Y and writing the data item Y. Okay. So now the T1 wants to, what it wants to, it has to again lock exclusive lock on Y. But it's not possible because it's already locked by T2. Lock X, read X, write X. Up to this condition, the process works in a serializable way. But come to here, here the deadlock is occurring because here lock X, Y, exclusive lock on Y. But here it is already locked by the T2 transaction. Means here it is waiting. So it has to wait to read the data items Y. The T2 transaction has to release the lock. Until it releases the lock, this process has to wait. Waiting for T2 to release lock on Y. So to release lock on Y, this state has to wait. Okay. At the same way, here also, this exclusive lock on X. X is already locked by transaction T1. So this operation will perform until this transaction releases the lock. So now it is in waiting state. Okay. It is waiting for T1 transaction. Sorry. T1 transaction to release which lock? To release lock on X. Okay. So these two are in deadlock conditions. If this wants to complete its operation, here the T2 transaction has to release Y. If this operation has to be completed, means here T1 transaction has to release lock X on data item X. Okay. So this is the deadlock condition. So let us see necessary conditions that are on deadlock. So what are the conditions for deadlock? So there are different types of different conditions will there. Necessary conditions on deadlock. So let us see what are the necessary conditions on deadlocks. So the first one is the hold and wait. So this is one of the condition in deadlock. So for holding and wait condition is also one condition to occur deadlock. Mutual exclusion. Next, no preemption. Fourth one is circular wait. Okay. So these are the different conditions that occurs the deadlock. Hold and wait, mutual exclusion, no preemption, circular wait. So first let us see what is this hold and wait. Okay. So hold and wait is nothing but a process currently holding resources that were granted earlier can request new resources. Okay. So how we can say this? Let us take a resource held by process P2. So this A resource is already held by process P2. But P2 is requesting process B. Okay. So P2 is requesting process B. So it is in wait state. So until the resource B is released, the P2 process is in wait state. But B is already held by process P1. So the process P1 is requesting resource A. So this you call it as a deadlock condition. So hold and wait deadlock condition. Here the process currently, here the process currently holding resources that were granted earlier can request new resources. So that you call it as hold and wait. So name itself is saying it is holding the data and it is waiting for the another resources to complete its process. So that's about the hold and wait. So next condition, that is a mutual exclusion. So what is mutual exclusion? Actually, the mutual exclusion is nothing but a process is requesting resources which is already locked by other process. So here a process is requesting resources which is already locked by other process. Or else you can say a resource may be acquired exclusive lock by only one process at a time. So here you can take the example, here the process 1 is there, process 2 is there. So what I said, process is requesting resources which is locked by other process. So this, it is requesting R2, but R2 is already holding by other process, okay, and R1 is holding by P1. So don't bother about this. So but here the mutual exclusion definition is the process P1 is requesting resource which is already locked by other process. So this condition you call it as mutual exclusion. Okay, so now coming to the next necessary condition, that is no preemption. So what do you call this no preemption? Actually, first see what is preemption. Preemption means, preemption means if your work is completed, then release the lock. Okay, suppose if your transaction is over, so if your transaction is over, then release the lock, then so other process can handle those transactions, handle those resources. That you call it as preemption. So then what is non-preemption? Non-preemption means after, even though your work is completed, it didn't release the lock, means it is holding the lock even after the transaction is over. Okay, after the transaction is completed, the preemption means it is not releasing the resource. Okay, the transaction is not releasing the resources after the completion of the work also. That you call it as non-preemption. Okay, so now see next condition, that is the circular wait. So in the circular wait also you can get the deadlock condition. Means here the X is there, X is requesting for Y, Y is requesting Z, okay, Z again requesting X. So all the deadlock will be occurred in circular condition. X is waiting for Y, or else waiting for Y, and Y is waiting for Z, Z is waiting for X. Okay, so this is a deadlock condition. Okay, so these are the different types of deadlock conditions, necessary conditions. So deadlock may occur in hold and wait, or it may be in mutual exclusion, or it may be non-permission, or it may be like circular wait. Thank you.